Maybe you saw a poll not too long ago, like within the past week, where a lot of people on both sides are saying, we could actually see breaking the country up. We could imagine that. And maybe we, now, it doesn't solve all problems, and I know you can nitpick me to death about what would happen next, and I understand that. But the key thing is for us to think outside of a box that has been put together for us by the New York Times editorial board. You know, that is our job here. I already have the Republican Party that's going to go out there and give pretty speeches about limited government and this and that and the other thing, okay? I already have that. If I want to hear pretty speeches about that and slogans from 1984, I meant the year, not the book, I can get that from the Republican Party. But from the Libertarian Party, I don't want people who are going to say, well, we could say X, Y, and Z, but that'll scare people away. Yeah, I think what's scaring people away is more and more the same damn thing over and over and feeling like no one's going to stop it. I mean, honest to goodness, I don't know about you. I don't know about you, but honestly, the thing that really does scare me the most is the idea that we'll just continue to coast along this crazy road forever. So if somebody comes along and says, I think we need to take a detour, that's not as scary sounding as it used to be, especially when the detour simply says peace. We're not going to defeat you and you're not going to defeat us. That's obvious by now. We've got a division here and it's not going to be overcome by you threatening us or you doing this or that because we're just going to resist you. So what if we just put our arms down, return to our homes and carry on in peace? That's our message.